Hey Pisces, welcome back to Key Wisdom to Roll. My name's Ruth, I'm your Reiki Master and Tarot Reader, and this, my darlings, is your intuitive in-depth reading for the time between the 21st of September and the 5th of October. We're going to look at September up here, we're going to look at October down here, and we're also going to pick out some key energies and outcomes for this time period, my darlings. I have meditated before, I've done this reading, doing my Reiki meditation so I can prepare for you, my darlings, and I have already shuffled the deck. I'll do a little bit more of that on camera right now, and then we'll get started on your reading. Okay, apologies about that. So my darlings, that took a while. We've got some clarifying cards here. I will know when they want to come out in your reading. Tiny is barking. And we've got Temperance at the bottom of your deck. Now, interestingly, we've got some clarifiers that have come out with their cards already. So we'll just put them there. Now, my darlings, card at the base of the reading is the overall energy of this time period, or the perspective you need to see this reading through, and for you guys it's Temperance. Now, when I was dealing these cards, the energy that I was, the name or the word that came to my mind were crossed wires. So the I always associate that sort of energy and that confusion with two cards, the Seven of Cups, and yes, you guessed it, Temperance. Now, the reason I associate that sort of cross wires, that sort of stifled energy, not wanting to move forward, but not knowing when to, not being certain when to, that is what it feels like in Temperance. So the energy of Temperance, even though it feels quite frustrating, is extremely healing. So for you guys, it seems like you're going to be, it's about being guided this during this time period, and about you listening to yourself, about you listening to both aspects of self, to your intuition, to your emotional body as well, which I'm sure, Pisces, you're very good at doing, but it seems like you've got something that you want to do, but it feels like it might be, you feel like it's taken you longer than it should. No. It's taken as long as necessary. So just stay with that energy, stay with that vibe, because that's exactly where you should be all this time period. Okay, we'll look at this one right at the end as your outcome, darling. This is your key energy, the first and most important message for this time period that we have. Okay, we always start with this card. And for you guys, it's the Page of Swords. Who you looking at, or who's looking at you? So Page of Swords, sword energy, our thoughts, mind, clarity, consciousness, communication, our awareness, what we allow ourselves to think and to understand, and how we communicate with other people. All those things are governed and ruled by sword energy. Okay, now pages are, we have page, we have Knight, we have King, we have Queen, and each of them, if you think about them, are graduating in maturity, so graduating in using and applying this energy, applying our logic, applying our reason, applying our awareness, and gaining clarity and understanding. So we graduate each stage through the page, through the Knight, through the King, through the Queen and King. So when we look at the page, we see that there's not a full mastery, a complete mastery, which means we're not clear understanding. So the page, active, masculine, which means we're doing things, we're taking action, we're going somewhere. It's about looking for information, searching for information, trying to understand, trying to work out, trying to gain clarity. And this is why sometimes we refer to this card as the stalker card, because it is online, looking things up, finding things out, looking at people, finding things out about people, or this person that you're interested in dating, or this business that you're interested in starting, or this job that you're interested in doing, okay? This employment that you're interested to find. So we are not there yet. We don't have the job, or we don't have the girl, or we don't have the man, or whatever it is, but we are looking, we are searching, we are trying to find this information out. So this is why, you know, we're taking action, yes, but we're measured in our approach, because we're trying to find that information out. And that's what it seems like for you. So what are you trying to look for? What are you trying to find out, Pisces, in the month of September? So let's look at September. These cards here are the last week of September. We're going to look at those first of all. First, we have my dog. I mean, hallelujah, we've got the Ace of Cups, we need to praise, we've got the Ace of Cups, okay? So this energy is all about our emotions, your emotions, it's water. It's about our emotions and intuitive body, yes. Oh my God, we've got two wands here. We've got Ace of Cups, we've got the Magician, which is one in the Major Arcana. We then have the Two of Pentacles with a clarifier, we'll look at that in a second. And we also have the Devil energy, and we'll look at the clarify for that in a second. So, my darling, absolutely beautiful energies, and let me tell all of them, and let me tell you why. I'm not being biased because of my Capricorn. It's just that as a Capricorn, I have obviously worked to spend a lot of time to try and understand where our interpretations of this imagery comes from, and so I can give you a lot of information about that, my darling. So we start off with the Ace of Cups. The Ace of Cups, number one. New beginnings, number one, inspiration, number one, independence, number one, self-leadership, number one, self-actualization. In fact, we can bring this one over here while we're saying all these things about the number one. We have new opportunities. We have luck and good fortune and presence of mind. Now, this number one, the Ace of Cups here, this gift that we have is of emotion. So it's about a new emotional beginning. It's about a new emotional connections. It's about you feeling more, you feeling more, you feeling more, you connecting with your feelings, you connecting with your emotions, and not only you feeling them, connecting with them, using them, but recognizing that it's that commitment to your emotions, temperance, see, and balancing, just like temperance is doing, is the thing that helps us with these two energies here to manifest, is the things that helps us to bring what's inside me, so what's inside you, out into the world, so we can see it, so that you can see it, so that you can see everything that you've learned, so that you can show everybody and show yourself really how far you've come and the things that you've gained, etc., etc. So these two cards are beautiful together here. You know, the Magician energy is it's about the balance of it's alchemy, really. That's what the Magician represents, alchemy. Making gold out of lead, you know, out of base materials. So it's like our experiences, if you will, are base materials. The things that we go through, the things that we experience, the challenges that we face, the difficulties that we face, they are the mundane or the lead, if you will, the base metals. And then as the Magician, you can see the blessings in them and you can turn those experiences into growth, into healing, into new emotional experiences, and new things that you want to bring into your life. And you're able to take the action, because it's masculine again, take the action to make those things happen, to bring those things out to the fore. Okay, so then we move on to what? 1 + 1 = 2. We've got the Two of Pentacles with a clarifying card. Now, twos are about commitments, okay? So look here, we're committing, you're committing to listening to your emotions, which is what I said here with temperance. It's a similar message in a way. apart from we're not manifesting necessarily with temperance, but what we're doing with temperance is we are listening and responding before we take action. We're listening to ourselves, we're listening to our intuition, we're listening to our feminine, our divine feminine, which is our the imprint that our experiences and the, have left us with, the wisdom that our experiences have left us with. Again, turning that lead, that those base metals, those base experiences into gold with the temperance. So we've got very similar energies. And you see I've moved my hands like this to and fro all the way through this reading. And then we get the two of pentacles. So twos, they're about commitments. We're committing to listening to our emotions and manifesting them. We're committed to finding out the information, doing the things that are necessary, coming into more information, coming into clarity. We are committing to listening and responding to ourselves. Here, this tells us two things. It tells us that this is something that's helping you to manifest. And we know this because it's Pentacles energy. Pentacles energy is all about where we put our energy and effort in order to manifest our security. So this is you doing this, being temperate, yes, but also the emotion that goes with that. Because this is the thing about when I was talking about crossed wires, right at the beginning of the reading. See, we've got crossed wires here, we've got crossed wires here. Also the symbol of infinity though and karmic cycles. I digress. But when I was talking about those crossed wires, it can feel clouded sometimes because when we're guided by our emotions and we're guided by this new information and this information seeking, it can be, we can sort of feel like I want to move quicker, I want to know more faster, but we have to just allow ourselves to come into the awareness that we're coming into, to build at the speed and at the rate that is right for us. So, but we know that you're committed to manifesting security in some area, potentially in love, potentially in self-love and in healing, in self-healing, in healing yourself, in healing your soul. Some of you are thinking about, how can I do that? What can I do to you're thinking about that in September, you know, what can I do to make my healing go quicker, smoother, you know, and you're looking for ways, you're finding things out online. You might be getting a tarot reading, for example, or you might be getting advice or going to a doctor, whatever. You know what it is for you in your life. But it's that type of energy here. And we've got it clarified with the Knight of Swords. So this is you wanting to race ahead with this, wanting to, as I said, find it faster, do it quicker. Now, I do a lot of work, obviously, as I always tell you, about the energies, and I work with the energies. And what I mean by that is I meditate. I meditate on the energies and I sit with them for a day or 2 days, and then I vocalize and write about what experiences I have with those energies and how they feel. And this is what I wrote about this and the Knight of, so the Knight of Wands and the Knight of Swords. So it's pushing through established boundaries, learning new things. The energy must come through and you must experience it, say it, live it, feel it. Opening up new channels and our experiences are being broadened, okay? We have reached our limit. So we've reached the limit of the Page of Wands, which is I've got this idea, I've got this feeling that I want to move. We've reached the limit of that. And now you're finding your boundaries, you're clearing out, you're pushing out, you're moving forward. And it's unsteadying and it's unstabling. And you might feel frustrated and there might be tension. And this is what I feel, this is what I mean about this cross wires, but this is the energy of temperance in a nutshell. So when I've done a video about temperance, actually, you can watch that. It's in my Key Wisdom playlist. So when I think about this energy, these energies of how we move and when we're like, yeah, okay, I'm ready now. I'm ready to date, or I'm ready to get a job, or I'm ready to, you know, apologize, or whatever it is you're ready to do in your life, improve my situation. You have that feeling, that impetus, and you want to go, you want to move, but we feel slowed down almost by temperance. But it's because temperance is saying, we need to be considerate about what we're doing. We need to be considerate about the things that we're trying to manifest here. We need to be considerate that we're taking the steps that are our wiser self moving forward. And that's what all these energies are really telling us, okay? But you are pushing outwards, you're moving into new territory as well. And what else? You're growing and you're maturing in your, with when we see these energies, we're growing and we're maturing in our ability to respond to our, not only our emotions and to listen to them, but to our instinct with wand energy, to our instinct. So your instinct is to move forward, and you are doing that. And as I said, some of you might feel confused or a bit frustrated, but this is really the energy that you should be feeling right now, especially we know that with temperance as the underlying. I mean, listen, temperance, man, it is not it seems like a very sort of mild and meek energy, and in a way it is mild and meek, but it's getting you to be mild and meek. And that's the thing. It's like when you are excited about something and you want to do something and you know you want to do it, you just want to go for it. But temperance is always that energy of, let me consider, let me research, let me find out, let me just, it's asking you always to reflect, to reflect, to reflect, to go back to your moon, to your divine feminine body, and to respond to those. Okay, so we've now have the devil energy. So this is September. So we're moving toward the end of September now with these cards here. Got the devil energy. So representative of the fabulous sign of Capricorn. I'm a Capricorn. And in a nutshell, I talk about the devil as a slavish commitment to responsibility that leads to our emotional and spiritual breakthrough. That is the energy in a nutshell of the devil energy, because we've got a number six here. Now it's number one, which is again, I've talked about number ones, and a number five, so 15, so one and five. And number five is all about change. So think about it, it's the beginning of change. It's this energy is about beginning of change, and it's about when we notice that the things that we feel are important, that we think are important, these responsibilities, these things that keep us tied, that keep our divine masculine and divine feminine tied to responsibility, as opposed to love, as opposed to compassion, as opposed to the joy and the pleasure of our lives. When we feel tied to those responsibilities, that's when, and we notice it and we're engaged with it, that is when, number five, that is when we can begin to change those patterns. We can begin to change that behavior. And for you guys, that's exactly what's going on this month, you know, toward the end of September. You're realizing, okay, maybe some of you want to move so quickly because that's what your family expect. That's what your boyfriend expects. That's what your boss expects. And that's what you've always done in the past. But actually, now is about being temperate. Now is about listening, responding to what you feel. Let's have a look at this area clarified here. So yeah, you're just stressing about it, that's all. But it's good because number nine is about awareness. Awareness. And I've talked about awareness all the way through, and we've talked about responding and listening. Awareness. So this is literally becoming aware of these things that keep you tied to old ways of doing, old ways of behaving, old ways of thinking. This is literally you coming into that awareness, okay? Check out the video in my Key Wisdom playlist, Nirvana Illusion Awareness. It will explain very clearly. I look at all the nines in that video as well, actually, including this one. And it explains very clearly why the significance of the number nine and the significance of energies like the Nine of Swords, because the Nine of Swords is obviously linked to the Hermit energy. The Hermit energy is about being guided from what is within, allowing your inner light to guide you, connecting with your inner self, yourself, your true self. So the Sword energy, again, thoughts, mind, clarity, consciousness, communication. This is it all being laid bare, seeing everything, recognizing everything, looking at all the behaviors that have kept you stuck, all the behaviors that have kept you behaving in the same ways. Now it's time for new. You are in that energy where now in September, because of our astrology, let's look at the astrology. Look, the end of September, this is the astrology that we've got coming forward to. Saturn direct in Capricorn. You know, you've got Saturn here, you've got Capricorn here. And these are the energies of, and then we've got balance with Libra coming in on the 23rd and 28th. So we've got this awareness, this I can see clearly now, I can see clearly now, all that stuff, yeah? This is what we're seeing. So we still have our clarifying cards here because we've not looked at them yet, but I'm just going to just do you these before I forget. This is my, well, your thumbnail. Okay, so now, my darlings, let's look at October. So we're moving into October now. We're moving into October and we start October with a another nine. So we've got 9, 9, 9, 9, multiple nines is activity, communication, shifting, all that stuff. And that's because the activity, the communication is because we are coming into awareness of how we think, what we think, what our responsibilities are, our identity, also how we feel, what moves us. We're becoming more aware with number nine. So the more number nines we've got, the more awareness we're coming into. Yes, we've got the Three of Cups next. Then we have the Eight of Pentacles and we have the Six of Swords. So look at the difference with a clarifier. So look at the difference. These cards are winking at me now, just a second. So look at the difference. That's there. That we have with, as we move into October, we have calmness coming. We have reasons to be cheerful. Reasons to be cheerful. 1, 2, 3. That's a song. But you have reasons to be cheerful because what is happening as a result of this awareness, this temperance, this listening, the research that you're doing, the work that you're doing, what's happening as your understanding grows is you recognize, you see the walls that you had built up, and you understand, you start to understand why these walls were built up, whether it was emotionally you had walls built up, you were restricting yourself, or you were restricted and you didn't even know you were restricted. Again, watch the video, Nirvana, Awareness, Illusion. Watch that video. It explains what I mean by that. You are coming into that awareness now and you start to understand, okay, this is why in the past it was hard for me to manifest the things that I wanted to create the life that I wanted to have specifically the things that were needed for me to feel good and happy and strong in my life. You are starting to understand and come into the awareness of what those things are and were specifically. And not only that, you're also coming into awareness of how they affected you, how they affected your actions, how they affected your emotions and your self-esteem. And we can see that very clearly demonstrated here because the universe is going, yes, queen, you've done it. Now, you know, I'm laughing when I say that, but this is, I love the threes, actually. I love the threes because they are about expansion, and expansion is about awareness, okay? So being illuminated and, you know, having these illusions that we're living under being, you know, destroyed and crushed, not crushed, but so that we can see beneath the veil of those things. And though that awareness is always something that brings more into our life, it helps you feel more. I think about it as, it's a physical feeling for me. So for me, when I go through Kundalini awakenings or even awareness, when my awareness changes or shifts, literally I notice the space within my body, literally the cells and the muscles and the bones within my body, I feel more. I release literally physically from my body and I notice how that feels. And that's because I practice mindfulness, meditation, Reiki, okay? They all allow me to be so connected and in tune with my physical experiences as well as my emotional experiences and my mental experiences. So this is for you. This is why I love threes, because they're about our growth and expansion. And that means you becoming more you, you feeling more you, you being connected more to yourself, to your true self, in this instance, to your true emotions, and recognizing that, yes, you know, I am able to celebrate now. I am able to recognize how well I'm doing, how far I've come. And then we've got this clarified by the Four of Pentacles. So this is showing that it's this that's over. So when you felt in September, you felt this energy, this impetus to move, to go, to do, to create, to manifest, and you felt slowed down by this energy. So this is you feeling great and on it and happy and ready to go and ready to manifest and feeling really good about yourself as you enter this time period, you know, this week, 21st of September. But then also, it's almost like this awakening that you have that makes you feel all these things, this awakening that you have in a way also highlights and shines a light on a truth within yourself. You become aware of something that has in the past limited and restricted you, limited and restricted your emotions, your ability, not emotions, not ability to feel them, but maybe ability to share them with people and manifest them in some way that's appropriate and balanced for you, that made you feel comfortable. So now you have in September this breakthrough of, oh my God, I know now, I understand why I felt restricted in my emotions, or I understand why I felt restricted in my relationships, or I understand why I felt restricted in my ability to have the success I wanted professionally, for example. So you have that understanding, and that understanding, as I said, it's sobering in a way. But what this shows us is you have a couple of days maybe feeling a bit shaky about it. But what this shows us is that wait is over. So now you're able, as you enter October, beginning of October, you're able to actually move on the things that you've learned and come into those awareness. You know, fours are about our foundations. And this is where you've come from, really. You've come from a place where you weren't able to put work into manifesting the type of things that you wanted to, because it wasn't time to. This energy exists, like all the archetypes in the tarot, because they are necessary for us to experience at times. So sometimes it's necessary for us to sit and to wait and to allow that awareness to come to us, which is what happens now. You can celebrate. We have then the eight. This is clarifying. Oh. I thought it was but it's not. Then we have the Eight of Pentacles. Again, more pentacles. So again, you've got to think about pentacles as being things manifested, security manifested, money in your hand, actions that you take and the results of those actions, you know, cooperation from other people, business, a job offer. You know, you've got to think of pentacles as real solid things, relationships, children. But this is in essence, because eights are about our karmic cycles, the things that we go through, the things that we learn, the things that we understand because of our experiences, what we learn about ourselves, our inner selves, our true selves, our soul selves, from our experiences that are external to us. That's Adam and Eve, divine masculine, divine feminine. That's why we have karmic cycles and the purpose of them, if you will. This is about, okay, working on your karma, working on your healing, working on what you have learned. That's what this is. It's bringing out the things that you've learned. Again, as I keep saying it, manifesting the things, showing yourself by your actions, by the things that you do, that yes, I have learned this, I now understand this, and I'm moving on. I'm going to take different actions now, or do things differently now, or, you know, because of what I've learned, because of the knowledge that I've gained, you know, I'm calmer now in my thoughts. You know, we've got another number six here. So we've got six here with the devil, 15, and we've got six here. Remember, the love is number six as well. So this is why the devil card is related to that union, that understanding, that love that we feel for ourselves. But it's the things in our lives, in a way, that the responsibilities or the things that we're tied to. Sometimes that's why people call it the addiction card. That's lazy in my opinion, but whatever. There's so much more to it. The things that we are tied to that have the greatest potential for us to come into awareness and to make changes that can stay with us. And that is really what Saturn's there for. That's what Saturn is. It's a taskmaster, and it says, what have you learned? Because if you have learned what you should have been learning, then you get your rewards, and Saturn gives you the best rewards, you know, because they are manifested rewards. They are things that are different. They are things that change your life, change your experiences, literally from day to day, your actions, your feelings, your mental capacity, you know, your mental processes. And this is just a further example of that. Another number six of swords. Number six on the tree of life is beauty. And I always think of beauty as something that we recognize as beautiful or significant or as of having value. So this is you realizing, you know what? Yeah, that was hard. That was hard, you know, learning that. That was hard waiting. That was hard, you know, being where I've been for the last 6 years for some of you, for the last 6 months for some of you, for the last 6 weeks for some of you. It was hard being there. But do you know what? I learned so much. I understand so much now about myself that I didn't and I wouldn't have known if I hadn't have had that experience. So thank you, Saturn. Thank you, Capricorn. And that's what this energy of the Six of Swords represents. So we've also got a clarifying card here. We've got the Six of the Seven. So, I mean, look, we've got six, seven, so we've got progress. So, you know, the Seven of Swords. I'm just going to drink a bit of water. Well, number seven is a number of mystery. It's my master number, actually, number seven. Number seven is a number of mystery. And what that, in a nutshell, means is why. Why? Why do I, in this instance, think that? Why is that my perspective? Why is that my belief? Why, or in your instance, why was that my perspective? Why was that my belief? So you are asking those questions. You are doing that work. And with this clarifier here, beneath this Six of Swords, it tells us that this is over. This is the, you know, all these energies here of trying to understand, trying to work it out, trying to come into it. You know, there's support here with this energy, because what this tells us is that your path continues, in a sense that you're going to be learning more. You're going to continue, obviously, excuse me, to learn more about yourself as you go through this next year, obviously, as you go through your life, obviously, you're going to continue to learn more and more about yourself and more about the old emotional you, the old way that you used to deal with your emotions, because we get, as I said, we've got this new way of dealing with emotions and not dealing with emotions, maybe sharing them, expressing them, telling somebody, people, etc. So this is a beautiful thing, because you're on a real beautiful soul journey at Pisces. This card has not wanted to come out yet. It still doesn't want to come out. So I'm going to put this one, which is our outcome card, okay? Our outcome card here for this month of October, and our second key energy is, yes, the Three of Wands. Now, I say yes because I saw this card earlier and we've got another three. So I talked about the threes and how much I love the threes. And this is the work that you did. Imagine you've been dragging that ship, dragging it over your shoulder, dragging it up over the hills and over the dales. And finally, you get the ship to the shoreline, to the sea. And you can relax now. You're like, yeah, man, things are going to be all right. So this is about, yeah, things coming toward you with the Three of Wands. But also, because you've got to think of the expansion that you've done, the work that you've done is what, the places that you're now going energetically, spiritually, the places that you're now going in your actions are the things that is the very, by its very nature, is what's drawing things to you as well. So it's a really beautiful energy in a way, this card, not of necessarily reciprocity, but of opportunities and of things of value coming into your life. Because of the work that you've done, you know, it's been a hard one. So we've got this, and we end with another seven. We have the Chariot energy here, which is Cancer's energy. And, you know, this is literally the getting into balance. So we started with the Temperance, we're doing this, and now we're finishing with this, getting into balance, our Divine Masculine, our Adam, okay, Adam and Eve, our Divine Masculine, or yin. I don't know which is yin and yang. I don't know which is divine masculine, divine feminine in Chinese. If the yin or the yang. I can't remember. But anyway, you get the point, yeah? So you've got... that's what this represents. So you've got the divine masculine, the yin, the out stuff, you know, the actions that you do, the actions that you take. And you've got the divine feminine, the our inner and inert wisdom, knowledge, understanding. The imprint of our experiences, what they taught us, what they taught you. And we've got those, you trying to balance those two things. So that means that the things that we do externally, the actions that we take, we're always listening to our inner wisdom, our inner guidance. And that really as well is the energy of Temperance as well, you know. But you, with this, it's masculine. So it's you driving that forward. It's you acting now, moving now. So even if you feel at the beginning of this time period, you know, stifled or uncertain or confused, you are continuing to do the work to push through that, to take the action to push through that. And it's that that brings you, that propels you forward as you move through the next couple of weeks. Okay, my Pisces, I hope you liked this reading. I did. It was lovely. Please give it a thumbs up. You can subscribe to my channel. Just click my little head that comes up somewhere and subscribe. And obviously, feel free to share this video on your WhatsApp, on your Facebook, with your friends, with your family, if you think it will help them. You can find the September astrology video in the astrology playlist. And you can look at the description below. Follow Key Wisdom Tarot on Instagram and on Facebook for extra little snippets. Don't forget, check out the Key Wisdom playlist for extra tarot meanings, as well as everything meditation, mindfulness and Reiki. I will be back with you guys at the beginning of October with a brand new love reading for the month. Okay, my darling Pisces, I hope you love that reading. I hope you have a fabulous couple of weeks, and I'll see you all again very soon for your brand new readings. Okay, take care, my darlings. Bye.